Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to make your text kind of follow a circle in Adobe Illustrator. And I'll give you some examples of what I mean here in a second. All right, let's get started. Okay, so here's an example of the style of text I'm talking about. It kind of goes out from the circle, almost like the rays of a sun. Unfortunately, there's no way to make your text flow down here to the next line, so you have to enter the text separately on each of these little paths. Now, I say there's no way that it could be done, it's just that I don't know how to do that, and I don't think it's possible, but maybe it could be done with a script or something like that. But I'll show you how to do it just the manual way. So let's create a new document. I'll go to Create New, and then I'll come up here to Print, then Letter, and then Create. Alright, and first we'll need to know how many lines we want to type on. So let's say we want 50 to go around a circle. So to do this, I'm going to go up here to my polar grid tool. And this is underneath your line segment tool. So I'll get on that. And then I'm just going to hit enter or return. And that'll bring up these options. You can also double click on this to get those to come up. Your default size doesn't really matter because we're going to be resizing this. But we want 1 in the concentric dividers, and we also want 50 in radial down here because we want 50 dividers. Okay, so we'll say okay. And then I can just click and drag to make my circle. I'm holding shift to get a perfect circle. I'm just going to hit D on my keyboard. That'll give me a white fill and a black outline. And I actually don't want a white outline, so I'll get rid of that. So I actually want to keep these inner lines, but I want all these lines out here to become text paths. First, I'm going to get on my group selection tool. I'll just select the outer circle and delete it. I'll select everything here. I'll come over here to my Pathfinder. Now, if you're not seeing these windows, you can just come up here to Window and everything's under here. Here's Pathfinder. And I'm going to use this one right over here, which is called Outline. So I'll click that once. And what that does is everywhere that two lines intersect, it will cut it. This line was connected and all of the circle was connected, but now each of these are separate little pieces. And I'm going to hit Command Y or Control Y to see what I'm doing a little better. Now I want to keep the inner lines, so I'm just going to get on my group selection tool and select them all by drawing a box around them. And then I'll cut them with Command X or Control X. Then I'm going to paste in front with Command F or Control F, and then I'll hide these with Command 3 or Control 3. So now I'm left with something that looks like a sun. Now I don't want each of these little pieces right here anymore. So what I'm going to do now is hit Q to get on my lasso tool, and I'm just going to draw around all of these like this. So I have just the outer pieces, I don't have the circle selected, and I'm going to hide those with Command 3 or Control 3. Now what we're left with is just those pieces. I can hit A to get my direct selection tool, draw a box around those, and delete them. And then I'm going to unhide everything. That is Option Command 3 or Alt Control 3 on a PC. So now I have these outer pieces, which are going to be my text paths. And I have my inner pieces, which will just be lines pointing at each of the text paths. I'm going to hit Z to zoom in a little bit, then get back on my group selection tool. And I'm going to get in between these and just draw a box that includes the center. And then I'll hide those with Command 3 or Control 3. Now I'll select all of these and I'll group these with Command G or Control G. Now I'm going to unhide with Option Command 3 and I'll group those with Command G or Control G. And now I can hit Command Y again and get back to our normal view. Now I want to just color these on the inside with a color. So I'm going to go ahead and choose green for that. So I have a green stroke on these. I can also add a stroke to these. So I'll put like a blue purpley stroke. Okay, so now we can see the difference between the lines and then the text paths that we'll make. Okay, so I'm going to hit T on my keyboard and just draw a big box of text that will fill with lorem ipsum. I'm just doing this so I can copy some of these. And I'm going to change my font to Montserrat. We'll go with Montserrat Medium. And now I'm going to use this text to fill these lines. Of course, you'll have your own text. You won't be using lorem ipsum like me. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in with my Z tool, which is right down here. And I'll hit T to get my text tool. Now, when I hover over one of these lines, it's going to change to the text on a path tool, which is what we want. So I'm just gonna click it once. And if it does this, where it kind of starts and doesn't give you enough room, I just undo. So Command Z or Control Z, and then I click on the other end of the path. Okay, and this looks good. Now all I need to do is get on my selection tool and pull this little inner line up so it's on top of it, and so it's right side up. Now we'll grab our next section of text and do the same thing. And I'll just go ahead and do a lot of these. I'm leaving them all upside down for now, and I'll just turn them all right side up at once. Now, when we get down here, for whatever reason, when I click on this side and hit paste, it doesn't show up. And so I'm gonna undo and click on the other side of the line. I'm not sure why that happens, but it's an easy fix. You can just undo and start your cursor at the other end of the line. Okay. So now I'm just going to go ahead and pull all these to the right side. Now some of them might not be lining right up to that point, so you want to make sure that this line on the left is moved all the way to the left. You can see that the inner lines are not lining up very well with the text, so I'm just going to click on those and just rotate those around like this. And now they look much better. I'm also going to resize these lines by holding Shift and Option and grabbing a corner and just pulling those in a little so they aren't crowding the text so much. Now there's one more thing I want to show you. If you want a little bullet point here, you can make an art brush. So to do that, let me zoom out with Command minus or Control minus. I'm going to hit P on my keyboard, and I'm going to draw a line about the same length as this line. So right about there. And now I'll hit D on my keyboard to give it a white fill and a black outline. I'm just going to move it over. Now I'm going to get on my circle tool by hitting L on my keyboard and just draw a tiny little circle. And I want it to be solid, so I'll hit Shift X to switch these right here, the fill and the stroke, and just pull it down like that. And I think I'll move this line a little bit over like this, so it just looks like a dot by itself. Now I'll select both pieces and come over here to my brushes and just pull it into my brushes. I'll get this dialog box that asks, what kind of brush do you want? And we'll say art brush and okay. All of these settings look good. We'll do stretch to fit stroke length and the direction is fine. So we'll say okay. Now we can select all of these green pieces and choose the brush that we just made. Our circles are kind of misshapen, so we'll change the stroke weight to 0.9 instead of 1. That's looking a little better. Let's try 0.8. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Okay, so now we have the effect we want. Now you might notice that some of your inner lines don't have the point, like these two here. And that's because these two are going the opposite direction. So to fix this, I'm just going to take the art brush I made. I'll hold Option to make a copy, and then I'm going to hit O and return. O is our reflect tool, and it's right over here. And I'm going to do a vertical reflect. Now I'll take that brush and make a new art brush. And everything can stay the same. But now I'll select those two inner lines and choose that other art brush. And that fixes the problem. So that's a way that you can get round infographic text to look like kind of like the rays of a sun. All right, if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, thank you.